Welcome back. It may be one of Western New York's most haunted spots and especially popular right around Halloween. So, of course, we sent Mike Randall out to check it out.
It was built as a church in 1885, did time as a funeral parlor, and now houses the Iron Island Museum. Some people believe it's a haven for ghosts.
How many ghosts are here that you know of?
There's many, many, many ghosts. They're shadow people. I've seen at least six shadow men and at least six shadow women.
The museum's ghostly reputation has been featured on national TV. Linda Hostretter, who works here, has a healthy respect for its spooky inhabitants.
I don't come in the building alone ever.
Linda's mom, Marge, gives tours and shares stories of her strange encounters in the building.
I saw a little girl in the hallway. I could make out her plaid skirt and her shoes and socks. I thought she was going to kill me.
Sometimes the museum cameras pick up unexplained happenings.
Our camera showed the ball rolling 2 feet by itself over towards one of the chairs.
And occasionally visitors get pictures of people who were never there.
A girl took this one again that was on a tour, and you can actually see what looks like a shadow sitting in the chair with their legs bent and everything.
Who are all these restless spirits? Well, they may have come with the building.
When we took over the building in August of 2000, there were 24 cremated remains left in the basement.
Those remains have since been buried, but the ghostly happenings continue.
People touching my neck once.
They offer tours here, and for really brave folks, even sleepovers.
And we've had people from Australia, Germany, England.
At Iron Island Museum, the welcome mat is always out, especially this time of year, for visitors from this world and the next. Mike Randall, 7 Eyewitness News.